that December 3rd, as we've just mentioned, is the International Day for Persons with Disabilities. And this year's theme is Leadership and Participation of Persons with Disabilities Towards an Inclusive, Accessible and Sustainable Post-COVID-19 World. The global crisis of COVID-19 is deepening pre-existing inequalities. And despite this, few countries have adequate mechanisms in place to respond fully to the health requirements and priorities of people with disabilities.
Ukona upendo kwa hatika wa bunge na mshahara. Umeza nitanyuki vile mina kuitahani juu ukikama round vitu zangu sound funny. We prefer kubaya mbuzi peremende kuliko kuplayboy wako kaka denge. Umenifunikia kwa mkebe mbaka na fall apart kachinua achebe.
From celebrity status to an accident that would blind him. Moses Kilonzo was born with glaucoma, a condition that damages the eye's optic nerve. And while the vision in one of his eyes had completely disappeared at the height of his musical career, where he was signed by Ogopa DJs, corrective surgery improved the vision in one of his eyes until that fateful night.
So we went for a performance in Kitengela, in a club in Kitengela. So after the performance, you know, a lady came to me and, you know, requested me to dance with her. At first I refused, but she pushed and pushed and pushed. And so my colleague told me it's only wise to just dance with her just for 2 minutes. I didn't know that the lady had his guy there. So I think the guy felt like, you know, the guy had a bottle of beer. Na haiku imefunguliwa, it was full. So he hit me on my right eye, unfortunately, with a bottle. So I fell down. I was bleeding and I was taken back to the hospital. You know, the hospital couldn't save my eye, and that's how I lost my sight.
Life changed, he says.
As a young person, you know, you are at your prime age at 17, 18, is when, you know, you're focusing on your dreams. You want to be this, you want to be that, you want to go to school. You have your dreams set, your ambitions. But now here comes a disability. You've lost your sight. You know, priorities need to change first to accept.
Many would taunt the now visually impaired Moses.
And, you know, people used to laugh at me. You know, they used to some of my friends actually used to ask me, now, you lost your sight when you were in Form 4 and you're not working, you're not educated. Sasa utaoa msichana wa nani? Nani atakukubali ukiwa hivi? So all those things, you know, gave me a challenge. You know, they propelled me.
A young man with big dreams and an even bigger vision.
And I'm from a very humble background. So my dad passed when I was 3 days old. So I was brought up by my mom. And she was a preacher. So we didn't have a lot of money. So even paying for my rehab for her was a hassle. So I never went to any rehabilitation center. I rehabilitated myself. So I pretended I was okay. I used to go wash dishes, you know, mop the house just to keep my mom happy, even though I knew I was not okay with that. You know, I used to go and close myself in a bedroom and start crying, but make sure that my mom didn't see me cry, and then wipe my tears, you know, splash cold water on my face and say, Moses, okay, you need to focus because you're still alive and you have a life ahead of you.
And while the law in Kenya requires that both public and private sector employers reserve 5% of jobs for disabled persons, job opportunities remain a pipe dream for persons with disabilities.
I've applied for so many jobs. You know, people go and look at my resume. They are like, this guy can perform. Eh? Let's call him for an interview. And so after you get in that room, that interview room, they are like, are you Moses? I'm like, yes, I'm Moses. and all this work, you did all this.
Moses says economic empowerment of persons with disabilities will be a significant milestone towards achieving social, political, and economic inclusion.
Persons with disabilities are able, they can plan for people and not sit back and wait to be planned for. You know, they can take part in building this nation and not sit back and wait for others to build the nation on their behalf.
Professor Margaret Kobia, the Cabinet Secretary, Ministry of Public Service, Youth and Gender, says the government is committed to capacity building in rehabilitation, embracing technology for assistive devices, and generation of local solutions for PWDs.
About 1 million Kenyans experience one form of disability or the other. That is disability in terms of physical disability, mental disability, visual, and all other forms of disability, which means that segment of 1 million Kenyans are vulnerable in terms of how they're included in the society, how they access various services, various how the kind of infrastructure that they encounter to be able to be inclusive.
The government acknowledging that the number of persons with disability in public service remains low.
The society is much better. We are better off if we give equal opportunities even to people with disabilities to make a contribution to national building.
The law requires that the state takes measures to ensure the youth, PWDs, minorities and marginalized groups have access to relevant training opportunities to associate, access employment and to be protected from harmful cultural practices and exploitation.
In 2018, the government of Kenya and the government of UK held the first global disability summit in the UK. And in that summit, Kenya committed itself to implement action relating to inclusion, accessibility of the infrastructure, recognition of their health rights, recognition in education, and also ending stigma.
The government has attempted to protect the rights of PWDs through initiatives such as affirmative action by way of offering tax incentives. More than 1 billion people are living with some form of disability across the globe.
So the chorus Avril used to sing, baby, 1 + 1 makes 2, but you and me, we make 1.
Baby, 1 + 1 makes 2, but you and me, we make 1.
And then we would chant, piga kengele, baby.
Piga kengele, baby.
Piga kengele, baby. Piga kengele, baby.
Piga kengele, baby.